questions?
Of course, I'm open, I said. I'm here now for discussion, for questions, for suggestion, for everything.
The first drawing you show with the coils in the middle and connected and the heat comes out at that point. Why do you need to make heat? You can put on a transformator and transform the energy.
Yeah, in the old way.
Yes.
You don't need here. You wind the coils and multiplication will be at the point of the anode and you get enormous heat, and heat is electricity also.
If I want electricity, not by making steam with heat, but I want electricity.
From what?
For everything electric in my house.
Yes, you get electricity on this way, you have to go over steam turbine. Because you, if you want to multiply, you have to transfer that heat into electricity. The only known way now, until now, is over steam turbine. Because you get multiply, high current, high heat in the middle, and that means high current. And you add as much those as you want, heaters for the boiler, put a boiler, steam, and that is the only way, really. But you multiply, I said you, okay, if you had a 50% losses, then you can multiply 1 kilowatt into 2,000 kilowatts, into 2 megawatts. Because you have multiplication, 4,092. And that means huge. Even if the losses are big, if they were also 70%, then you have enormous output. Okay. I'm not propagating that. I'm not suggesting you to do that. What I'm going to do, I'm going to make one free energy motor, small fission, and give you to the house. And you don't need to multiply to connect with neighbors, probably. There are still tensions between neighbors, and then will be a little bit difficult to organize that. It's still everything doesn't function so perfectly, but you know, then you would be totally independent.
But when you go back to the design of Tesla, he made a receptor of electricity and can transform it to make usable electricity to burn your light or whatever.
Yes, that's
you
a question.
From the field, the energy, and transform it in usable electricity.
Yes.
Not by making steam.
Yes. In which kind of device?
Yeah, I don't know.
How do you know that he made it?
I saw some things he made on the internet, and it didn't look like steam engine. More like transformers.
There is a concept from Tesla how you can collect so-called radiant energy. They have called it radiant energy from the air and transform it direct in the electric current. I'm not sure that it has ever worked good and properly. And first of all, I'm not sure that pattern that is existing on the internet is original. It's a most probably it is faked, because everything what was put into circulation was first faked and then put into circulation in order to, you know, and it is possible for sure what you mean to make simple concept to create electricity direct out of air. So, how to say, I would like to share with you, I had a long years communication with Tesla and designing that concept. I have one final concept of it also, using just coils, properly designed and properly placed and interconnected. And we'll see how and if it works. But before I test it and really see, I cannot share with you anything. That is now an idea and a concept. And so my expectation is that it will work. It's possible, of course it's possible, because everywhere in the air is the omnipotent source. Each point in the universe is omnipotent source. If you create appropriate tap, you can open up source of unlimited energy, as much as you wish. And that is the base of the new concept of energy. Create there, where you need. If you move your car, you don't need to stop today. Everywhere you move your car, it will work. In any house, in everywhere. So, okay. Yes?
So from my imagination, does it still use an input?
Oh, this?
Yeah.
Of course. It multiplies here. That is...
It still uses source like a battery or something.
Yes, like yes. If you like to create out of air, you see here clearly, it's connected. You see, of course, to connect it from the outside, but multiplied to the 4,000 times. It depends, over unity, that's over unity. But it's possible to create, if you are smart enough, you would not take wooden coil and a full coil, double cone, you would take what? Where is the power?
Copper coil?
No. Where is the power? Where the power comes from?
Magnet.
No. Vacuum. You take, evacuate double cone, and then you have vacuum. And then you divide vacuum. That is how Creator creates. He has no wires, nowhere, and produces everything. No wires, no input and multiplication, no over unity, and creates sun, an enormous, huge source of energy. Suns and stars and everything. Each piece of matter is a high potential. That general law, same attracts same, can be understood. That high potential attracts high potential. Low potential attracts low potential. That is why gases go to heaven, and that is why this apple drops to the earth. It opens up now, it is challenging for you. It is challenging for you to think about it. How really you can create a tap out of vacuum. Because you must understand one point. I would like to share that with you. First of all, nowhere in the universe there is no more vacuum. Because that still universe of rest was expressed as a space full of the potential. And now what is called space is not a vacuum, is a full of potentials. So vacuum can be created just locally in a small pieces, small devices that we can evacuate. And we can have access to the enormous potential to dig out of it, to get out of it as much as we will, if we create some smart and efficient tap. That's a challenging. Because many, many laws that I mentioned here, and some that I didn't mention yet, there will come time, are in the play, and your genius is challenged to connect it and make successful concept. And in order to make it, you must apply following principle of creation. Give up the old way of creation, like you said, or you have trafo make it. That is all principle of creation, all principle of thinking. Opposite to that what Tesla used in his creations. He never started with I have a truffle, I have a magnetic field, but then never like that. I have one energy, I imagine that energy, how it moves. I have another energy, I imagine how energy moves, what is input and what is output. When I create clearly energy motion, the device comes from alone. I don't start from the device. I start in my imagination, move the energies according to the laws. And when I go in imagination, in meditation and connect to spirit, I see it clearly with my third eye, as I see with my normal eyes you right now. And you will see also it when you practice meditation and conscious breathing. Practice makes master. I'm sorry. I love breathing and I do breathing. And every morning, 1.5 hours jogging, breathing. And he knows. Every morning, huh? Yeah. You can do it also. So, in the state of half dreaming, even daydreaming, when you really place your intent inside on your heart and start living with that question, how, it opens, the door opens for sure, always, always. That is like the small kid who goes behind the father and why? The whole day, why? And at the end, the father says, come on, that is so. Our father is spirit, all-knowing, omnipotent. When we connect with him, it gives us the solution. Nothing what has ever been created in this universe is anything else than the creation of spirit. Since spirit controls each piece of matter, centers from inside, controls from outside, and only when you connect with the spirit consciously or unconsciously, you get ideas and create. And nothing in this universe is the new, and you cannot get any concept that is new. For a simple reason, that the one idea of creation is existent, and that is that still motionless universe, magnetic, light, still. Since one idea is existing, every other idea which is part of that idea is also existent. So you just need to take it. It exists already, that what you wish, or what you wish, or what I wish. It exists already. Pick it up, it is floating somewhere around. Go into meditation and grab it. So, when somebody says, I laugh now because it was my habit also, I have an idea. You don't have any idea. That idea is already existing. Yeah. You just open up and allow that idea to come into your reality. And then you decide if you will realize, materialize it or not. Every idea is already existing. So, nothing new you can create because whatever you take as a concept, it's already existing. It's a part of one whole idea of creation, which is existing, and each part is also existing. And that is easy for you to understand. The new era is era about I am creator also. Since I am one part idea of the one whole idea of creation, idea of a man in action. Since one idea of creation is infinite and eternal, and that part, idea which is me, is also infinite and eternal. And that is why I am creator also. And you can understand now why those who've been trying to separate you from the Creator have been doing it to deny, to cut off you from your omnipresence, omnipotence, and omniscience. And that is each and every one of you, me, each human being. That's nice, big truth. Very nice truth. That is time, new time. Time, I am Creator also. I am Creator also. Wonderful, 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 amazing. That is worth really to be born in a one lifetime, just to reach that truth. And then to start living that truth. Sometimes I think about it. We were taught that we are sinners and that we are small. And when I understood that grandness of ours, how angels with unlimited potentials, omnipotence and omniscience, allowed themselves to be fooled with such a belief system, not being aware of their own Creator's power. Unbelievable, unbelievable. And I say to the people, you are moving this universe. Who? Me? I cannot earn 100 euros to live the months. I'm moving, I'm moving nothing. It's really funny thing, no? To meditate about it. I suggest all of you to go into meditation, to make a conscious breathing, and to connect with spirit and to feel that omnipotence and omniscience, the beauty, that stillness that you reach in meditation, that is you. That is the power. That is the spirit, that stillness, when you are totally still and connect within. And there is nothing more and nothing more beautiful in the existence than that connection with self. And the whole challenge and the reason for coming here and living lifetimes is to love self and to trust self. Yeah, because each experience is a just an experience of your soul. So you are that love, and you create something in order to challenge that self-love, your self-trust. And when you now know mentally and experience through the conscious breathing that you are really, really that Creator, that spirit, that soul, you'll just laugh about any experience. Never judge anything else than good and self, first and foremost. Love self and trust self. And that is the secret. And that is why we are coming and taking physical body and choosing some experiencing in order to challenge and test our self-love and self-trust. Whenever you judge it differently, then you failed to pass that exam, and then start again and again. Create new challenge, a new challenge, and so on. That's interesting to explain how it works in life. Some tried in whole many lifetimes to love self and didn't succeed. And always, and to trust self, always found some outer sources to trust them to manage their reality, to influence their reality. And then finally, they create for themselves heavy disease, ALS. Nobody can heal it. And then realizing, now I cannot accept any help from the outside. Nobody can help me, doctors, nobody. And now that is the challenge. Now I must trust myself and my omnipotence over self-balance. It is the basic universal law of self-balance. And we possess ability to balance ourselves. And it is forgotten ability because we are programmed totally brainwashed, mindwashed, and everything else. And now we come into the truth and discover that we can balance ourselves easily. When we start, trust self and love self. Easy.
Why?
What why?
Why? Why the test?
Why the test? That's a nice question. Why at all the test? That comes to the beginning. One idea and one desire to express that idea through the knowledge. You cannot express an idea within self, must go out of self. And why? Because you are that love. When you go out of self and create in imagination as a mental somebody or some other condition, you forget who you are, because the will here on the earth of the, which is called magnetic, is electric wheel, goes into your DNA and cut off your remembrance to that who you are. In the age of 1 to 3 years, you remember still you are an angel, yeah, and you know, it will sit in the angle and laugh because you are connected with angels, and the parents think, what is that kid, is crazy, you know. But it is an angel. And then you program him, you cannot that, you cannot that, you cannot that, no, nine, nanny, and so on. And then in the age of 5, 6 years, that connection with spirit, it disconnected, and the kids start cheating, start all the games that we are doing, drama games, and become human, and forget that they are angels. And then comes that why. Create and challenge that the light in them, that love, light, but not that is motion. Motion is light is not motion. Light is the stillness of the eternal universe of rest. That is light. This is simulation of light, what we perceive as light. Light is them, the most powerful force who finally conquers all the challenges, and each and everyone will finally connect with itself and become enlightened, ascended being, and create own universes. And that game has no end. We will be meeting eternally, creating universes, playing different games. Yes! Do not doubt that. You will see. I will remind you. When I meet you somewhere in the universe, I will remind you of this one. That is why the whole purpose of life is to know self. I cannot know self within self because I am all there is. I must go out of it. I told about it. And I cannot go out of it because I am all there is. I cannot only go out in imagination, imagining something. That's a mental game. That's why this everything is a just game. Unreal. Unreal. We perceive that real. That's a nice. We all know that sensual pleasures are wonderful. I love all of them, of course. But from the other side, I'm fully aware that I am that still observer who is choosing something to experience and see all my experiences from that point of view. All of you create some challenge for your self-love and self-trust. And all of you who are identifying yourself with your body, when you look in the mirror and see that I have a nose, a big nose, it's nice, I have no hair, you know, I cannot love myself because there are others that are more beautiful, you know. But they also have another problem. And so until you understand that you create your body in order to test and challenge your self-love and then start love yourself and enjoy the life, everything is perfect. Everything okay with you, except your own judgment. Change the attitude. Happiness and freedom is an attitude. Prisons, jails are full of the free people, whereas most of those who are outside are not free. They are slaves. Because those who sit, that's true. Freedom is an attitude. Nobody and never can take out of you that Creator's given right to feel free. It's an attitude. So feel free means also doesn't depend of the material wealth, of the what other people think about you and how they judge you, and you don't care. You can sit the whole day on the street and bet and get €5 and go to drink beer and be happy. It doesn't matter, it's experience. You are still that soul, beautiful soul, spirit who is just experiencing it and nothing more. Life is about it. There are wonderful stories. I love one story. I'll share with you one story. If you have time. There was a guy in one village who was enlightened, ascended. Some poor man. And the king knew about him. And one day was going there, passing there, and told him, we have some celebration in my palace on that date, and I invite you to be my guest. And he said, thank you very much, it's my honor, I will come. And at that day, the poor man, in such a close, very few clothes, and so on, came in front of the palace, and the guard looked at him, because all the people coming to that celebration were, you know, people belonging to the elite and so on. And the poor guy, you invited here. You must be joking with us. What? They throw them away. And the guy was thinking, look at it, people in suits and so nice, others, everything. And he went back and took nice suit and so everything and came again back, and the guard saw him, please come in. He went in, sat on the table, and then all those people were drinking, eating, and I took drink and in this pocket, and I eat in this pocket. And all they were looking at him, crazy. They were eating and he putting in pockets of the nice suit, cakes and everything, answered, you know, making it dirty. Why? What are you doing? But that is not for me. This suit deserves it. It's for him, because without it, I couldn't come in here. So that's the belief. You know, that's belief system. It's a nice story. How everything can be turned into the love whenever you succeed in your life, to love for the self condition, self circumference any situation, you know you are connected with the spirit, and you absorb that situation and you pass that exam. When you really from the heart can laugh about self, when it is about self. And then you can go further. Make joy about from everything. Joy and love. Like in this Yula concept, the whole creation is interplay between joy and love. Love inspires joy to give permanently. Joy inspires love, pardon, to give permanently. And love is desire for give. And that is why this creation, answer to your question, is result of that desire for give. Because joy inspires love. Forgive, give, 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 and love. Giving is the love principle. And that is why always when you are in a position in your life to give, give it. Don't think about reward. It will come. I love this time when he talks so open and so relaxed. And so for me, the whole presentation is also like that. I come here to share something with you and to enjoy that energy and connection with your spirits and with your beautiful souls. And I know that all of you are all souls who have tried in the many lifetimes to reach the freedom and to reach the sovereignty and didn't succeed until now. But now you are very close and all of us will do it together as a group. And that is nice. Nice. That's why I love you, all of you. I love you, all of you. And we are really all the same group of people here, quick, little bit, and free and sovereign and so. It's an attitude. Freedom is an attitude.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, my friends. And so it is.
So it is. Thank you, Frank.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nou, het is wel een nice host. Een stukje kennis waar we al een paar keer naar moeten kijken, denk ik zo. Maar goed, daar is de film mooi voor. Dan kun je het herhalen en dan komen we er wel uit.
Thanks, Frank.
Okay.
Thanks.
Dank je allemaal.
Have a good night. Enjoy the life. So.
Okay.